हेलो एवरीबडी, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो एज यू नो, वी ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड विथ द चैप्टर कंपार्टमेंटल मॉडलिंग। इन दैट ऑलमोस्ट हाफ एन मोर चैप्टर वी ऑलरेडी फिनिश बिफोर इन दिस इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स। ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस रिमेनिंग इन टूडेज लेक्चर। ओके, सो हियर इज द कोट ऑफ द डे, डोंट बी द सेम, बी बेटर। ओके, इफ यू यू विल डू द सेम थिंग्स एज एवरीबडी इज डूइंग, देन इट विल बी ए कॉमन थिंग। ओके, वेन एवर यू विल डू डिफरेंट थिंक, देन यू विल बी रिकॉग्नाइज बाय द पीपल। ओके, सो डू द बेटर देन अदर्स। ओके, सो विद दिस कोट वी विल स्टार्ट टूडेज सेशन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द वन कंपार्टमेंट ओपन मॉडलिंग, देन टू कंपार्टमेंट मॉडल्स वी स्टार्टेड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर। ओके, इन दैट टुडे वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द मेथड ऑफ रेसिड्यूल्स। ओके, विच वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द वन कंपार्टमेंट ओपन मॉडल। ओके, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस रेसिड्यूल इन द मल्टी कंपार्टमेंट मॉडल। ओके, व्हाट तो मेथड ऑफ रेसिड्यूल इज बीइंग और यूजफुल फॉर टू द एक्सपेरिमेंटल डेटा ड्रग फॉर यू केस ऑफ मल्टी कंपार्टमेंट ओपन मॉडल। ओके, व्हेन वन कंपार्टमेंट ओपन मॉडल इज नॉट फॉलोड, दैट टाइम the method of residual in case of multi compartment model is used over there. Okay, suppose we will take one example. If 100 mg of drug is administered by rapid IV injection, okay, to a 30 kg of the healthy adult male, then blood sample were taken periodically and the following data were obtained. So one example is here, which explaining regarding one patient is there, and that patient have administered 100 mg of drug, or the your dose administration is there, and that person having 70 kg weight, and it is a obviously healthy male patient. Okay, and after administration the blood samples were taken periodically from that patient's blood. Okay, so here is the data is generated. Okay, you can see in this table. So in this table you can observe different drug or the blood sampling time points are there. Okay, so first of all, blood sample is taken within a 15 minute or at a time point of 15 minute, then it is taken at half an hour, then it is withdrawn at 1 hour, then 1.5 hour, then 2 hour, 4 hour, 8 hour, 12 hour, and 16 hour likewise. And you can observe here the plasma concentration of drug obtained in that blood sample or withdrawn sample, which sample we had taken from that healthier male patient. That sample shows the plasma concentration of that particular drug. So you can observe here at a initial time point of the blood sample, the maximum amount of a drug was obtained in that case. Okay, okay, so you can observe the it is 43 ml. Okay, or you can say 43.5 percent of the drug were obtained at the initial time point level. Okay, and with the increasing of the time, it is going to the decreasing order. So the both these are at opposite to each other. So let's see the graph. So in graph you can observe, after plotting of this graph, a curve line is observed. Okay, so this curve line relationship between logarithm of the plasma concentration and the time indicates that drug is distributed in more than one compartment. Okay, then from this compartment, by exponential equation may be derived, which is Cp or the plasma concentration is equal to Ae minus At plus Be minus Bt. Okay, so you can observe in this graph the by exponential curve is there, and it is the decline in the initial distribution phase. You can observe over there at a 50 time point, or the wherever denoted as a 50. Okay, then the decline in the initial distribution phase is more rapid than the elimination phase. So distribution phase is more rapid as compared to the elimination phase. Then rapid distribution phase is there, and it is confirmed with the constant A being larger than the constant B. We can observe over there. Then at some later time, Ae minus At will approach as a zero. It will become as a zero, and while Be minus Bt still have some amount of value is there. Okay, because elimination is still remaining over there, that's why some amount of value is remaining over there. And in case of the Ae minus At, in that case distribution or the absorption is a zero. Okay, so the rate constant and the intercepts were calculated by this method. Okay, so you have to understand, or you have to keep in your mind, this rate constant and the intercepts were calculated by using the method of residuals. So let's move toward next slide. Therefore, from this information we can say plasma concentration is equal to Be minus Bt, and after taking this in a common logarithms, we can say log Cp is equal to minus Bt upon 2.3 plus log B. And from this above equation, the rate constant can be obtained from the slope, which is minus B upon 2.3 of a straight line representing the terminal exponential phase, which is already we had seen in the that previous graph. Okay, then the T half of the elimination phase, beta half life, we can say, can be derived from the following relationship. So T half we can calculate from this relationship. So T half B is equal to 0.693 upon B. So from the example, B was found to be 0.21 hours. From this information, the regression line for the terminal exponential or the B phase is extrapolated to the y axis, and y intercept is equal to B or the 15 micrometer per ml. Okay, so here are the some values are there at a different different time points are there. Okay, you can observe 15 minute time point is there, then half an hour is there, 1 hour is there, then 1.5 hour, 2 hour, 4 hours, 8 hour, 12 hour, and 16 hours. Okay, so these are the time points, and these are the other three columns are showing the different plasma concentration values. Okay, so second column explains about the observed plasma level concentration values, which we already discussed in a earlier table. Okay, so second one column shows that the extrapolated plasma concentration. Okay, and third one is showing that the residual plasma concentration is there. So from this above table, we can say that the values from the extrapolated line are then subtracted from the original experimental data points, and a straight line is obtained. Then this line represents the rapidly distributed phase is there. Okay, so the new line obtained from the graphing the logarithm of the residual plasma concentration Cp, plasma concentration Cp minus Cp against the time represents the phase. The value for A is 1.8 hour and Y intercepts is 45 microgram per ml. Then elimination half-life, or T half we can say, computed from the B has the value of 3.3 hour. Okay, so from this above table and that previous graph, we can predict this one. Okay, so a number of pharmacokinetic parameters may be derived by proper substitution of rate constants A and B and Y intercepts A and B to the following equation. So following equations are there. So K is equal to AB in bracket A plus B upon AB plus BA, and after taking K1 to 2, if kinetic is from one first compartment to the second compartment, in that case what will happen? AB into B minus A square, okay, upon A plus B into AB plus BA. And if that kinetic is from second compartment to the first compartment, in that case AB plus BA upon A plus B. So this was regarding the two compartment open model. Okay, and now we will discuss regarding the three compartment open model. So three compartment open model contains three compartment. Okay, then basically three compartment made up of from two compartment model plus one deep tissue compartment is there. Okay, so you can observe here in the representation of the diagrammatic representation, tissue compartment is there, which is denoted as V1, C1 and D1. Then central compartment is there, which is denoted by Vp, Cp and Dp. Okay, and last one is a deep tissue compartment is there. So you can observe here the central compartment is there, which is which contains the highly perfused organs. Okay, which may be contain the tissue, kidney, liver, heart, likewise. Okay, and it distribute drug rapidly. Okay, and if we consider, or we will take the second compartment. So second compartment made up of from the different type of tissues, or we can say that compartment as a tissue compartment. So tissue compartment is distributed very less, or the less rapidly as compared to the central compartment, and third compartment is distributed very slowly, or the poorly perfused organs are there like bone and fats. As you know, as you already studied, bone and fat are the less perfused organs are there. Then rate of flow of the drug into and the out of the central compartment. If we consider this is a central compartment, and from this central compartment after administration, the rate of flow is how? or the at what will be the rate of flow is there from the central compartment. So let's see. So it may be Cp is equal to Ae minus At plus Be minus Bt plus A Ce minus A. Okay, so we can say AB and C are the y intercept of the extrapolated lines of the central tissue and the deep tissue compartment. And finally, we can say that A, B and C are the first order rate constants. Okay, then we can say in this the elimination rate constant. So elimination rate constant we can calculate by the K is equal to A plus B plus C into ABC upon ABC plus BAC plus CAB. Okay, then volume of the central compartment we can calculate by using VP is equal to D0 upon A plus B plus C. And finally, area under curve we can calculate by using A upon small a plus B upon small b plus C upon small c. So students, this was regarding the compartmental modeling or the overall the compartmental open modeling or the different type of compartmental modelings are there. So whichever part we covered in the today's lecture, which is not a part of your syllabus, so this is a part of actually compartmental modeling. So I had taken this one, but according to syllabus we are finish here, but we will not finish over here. We will take more lecture on it only because it is difficult to understand you people. So we will take more lecture on this chapter and this topics only, so you will get betterly or the greatly. Okay, so thank you so much for the day. We will discuss remaining or the we will revise all these topics in a next lecture. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you.